Today, I'll show you how to use the Scene Edit Detection feature in Adobe Premiere Pro. So Scene Edit Detection will automatically detect scene changes in flattened footage. Flattened footage is any video file that has been exported or rendered as a single layer with all the scenes merged into one video track. So any edits made to the original footage are no longer available. They've been baked in or flattened. And if you ever find yourself needing to recut flattened footage, say you need to reframe a scene or add an effect to a specific shot or transitions between shots, Scene Edit Detection can make things a lot faster. All right, to start, I'll drag this clip into the new item icon to create a new sequence. And for this tutorial, I'll be using a trailer for the film Joker Folie à Deux, which of course is French for please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. All right, so you can see this is a single continuous clip with a bunch of scene changes already baked in. And instead of recutting this manually, I'll right-click on the clip and go to Scene Edit Detection. And you'll get three options here. Apply a cut at each detected cut point, create bin of subclips from each detected cut point, and create clip marker at each detected cut point. And you can choose any one or any combination of these options. I'll show you the last option first, just because it's a little more straightforward. So we're going to select Create Clip Markers, then Analyze, and wait for the magic to happen. This will take anywhere from a few seconds to a few minutes, depending on the length of your clip. And when it's done, presto, I now have clip markers at every scene change. Okay, so let's undo that. Go back to Scene Edit Detection. And this time, I'm going to select Apply a Cut at each detected cut point and create a bin of subclips. Click Analyze, wait a few seconds, and now, instead of markers at each scene change, we have cuts. And over in the Project panel, Premiere Pro has created a bin with subclips for each detected scene in the video. I'll hit Option Shift 2 on my keyboard to toggle to the assembly workspace for a moment so you can see all these clips a bit better. And now I could easily work with the cut clips in my original sequence or just grab any of these subclips and build something completely new with them. I could, for example, randomly grab one of these subclips, do a little razzle-dazzle, and put together a fun little outro for this tutorial. 'Cause, you know, why so serious?